One of the difficulties that people, you know, seem to have when it comes to health insurance is that there are a lot of exclusions. You know, sometimes I'm saying even upfront, you know, applications are rejected.
Yeah.
Because of, you know, you have XYZ or your family member has XYZ.
Yeah.
Is that a reality, or, you know, is it that, you know, if you go through an aggregator like you, for example, chances are you'll be able to pick and choose, like you talked about the OPD, you know, being covered, or, you know, this ability to enhance automatically for a certain period of time.
Yeah.
One doesn't hear much about these things from at least insurance companies.
Yeah.
So are there a lot of different policies and plans out there today than, say, there were 3 years ago, which are far more cleaner, if I may use the word, you know, more open and transparent, and not some little asterisks down there telling you that, you know, sorry, but this is not covered, you know.
Okay. See, on this, what I would want to say is that, see, health insurance in terms of products and in terms of features has gone through an evolution, right? So there were general insurance companies, and in the last 10 years, we've seen about 6 specialist health insurance companies. Now there are about 7 who've come up with more feature-rich plans, right? And when I say more feature-rich plans, also means that the kind of coverage that they're giving is more broader, so that at the time of claim, as you rightly said, the rejection is lower, right? The reason they're doing it is because they've realized that consumers have become smart enough. They have the aggregators like us, like Policy Bazaar, have put the information in a very transparent way for a consumer to know that, okay, these are things which are covered, these are things which are not covered. Things which are not covered, this is the hit that I will get at the time of claim, right? So, because of which insurance companies, and especially the, you know, the specialist health insurance companies, have evolved the features in such a way that the consumer now can get a very feature-rich plan, and by not paying a very significantly high premium. So, yes, there has been a lot of evolution in terms of products, and the kind of, you know, as I said, the kind of features where consumers can eventually take a hit at the time of claim. And broadly, I'll talk about 2-3, not more. One is the room rent, right? So just to give you an example, so there are certain plans which say shared room, right? And in case shared room is not available, one up, right? Which means that, let's say shared room, the cost of a shared room is, let's say, 4,000 rupees, right? It's not available, and even the next category is not available, and you go in for a 6,000 rupee. Now, what happens is that because of the room, the associated expenses, whether it's pertaining to surgery, whether it's pertaining to a doctor visit, whether it's pertaining to anything else, right? Those also go up, which means that the consumer will have to shell that much extra from their own pocket, right? So room rent, I think, is a very critical piece. The second, which now mostly does not exist other than the higher age group, is the copay. I think these are the two broad things where consumers do get a hit at the time of claim. I think these are two things which consumers definitely need to look at while they're buying a health insurance policy.